sick. Watching my TV, checking out the news until my eyeballs fail to see. I mean, to say that every day is just another rotten mess. And when it's gonna change, my friend, is anybody's guess. So I'm watching and I'm waiting, hoping for the best. Even think I'll go to prayer every time I hear them saying that there's no way to delay that trouble coming every day. No way to delay that trouble coming every day.
Okay, I'm gonna ingest in the chemical body. I'm gonna light myself a cigarette.
Yes.
Really explain this. Let's go through a tetrad on the cigarette.
Okay, the cigarette enhances smell and gesture.
And what does it reverse into?
Well, it stylistically enhances. It enhances stylistic body posture, body language, like. The 30s and 40s, everybody's smoking on the movie screens, and looks pretty cool.
That's the beauty of it. They always, in cinema, the art of cinema, or I guess the visual medium of cinema, we should say, they always have to smoke cigarettes to make action happen, because basically there's nothing pretty much happening other than dialogue in
that's
the
right.
visual communication. So they say, okay, light up a cigarette and...
Fill in the gestures.
Yeah, I feel in the gestures, exactly.
Yeah, that's it. And then, so cigarettes obsolesces, well, you could say, fresh air, clean clothing, but you could say...
Yeah.
Obsolesces health, you could say.
Teeth, might obsolesce some teeth and some lungs,
It obsolesces the chemical body. That's what it does, because you're actually, the fad of smoking comes in the 30s with television, and people imitate the stylistic gesture, and the chemical body gets beat up over a long period of time because of that. Okay, I'll take that, and then it retrieves...
But as it retrieves the visual space of the visual medium of cinema. I mean, more or less, because now we can look at, Cary Grant or who's the other guy, Gone with the Wind or whatnot, some of the female...
The Greg guy.
And, I'm saying that's what it retrieves is more or less the golden era of cinema, because at all points
it doesn't retrieve it. It is the golden era. It's when it's in a medium. It's an environment in the 20s and 30s.
Go ahead, I'm listening.
Yeah, I was thinking of Greg. What is it? Cary Grant and then the other guy,
Gregory Peck.
Clark Gable.
There's Clark Gable, Gregory Peck, Cary Grant. And I guess the sinister guy, Brett or something, Gone with the Wind. Is that one of those three?
I thought it was Clark Gable.
That's who it is. Yeah. Clark Gable.
That's the name I'm searching for.
Okay, so it also retrieves, the cigarette retrieves, not the visual medium, it retrieves desire. It retrieves smoking dragon. It retrieves the penis and the quivering quim.
Now, Bob, check this out, man. I came up with a really wonderful idea.
We didn't do it. What's it flip into? It flips into, the milkshake. Think of some kind of consumption.
The roller skate?
No. It flips into some kind of mouth activity.
Oh, okay, yeah.
It flips into LSD. Or junk, or heroin.
That could be a possibility. Yeah, it would probably flip into smack, yeah.
Yeah, because cigarettes burn the lung, so drugs burn the brain.
Now, there's also the motif where Burroughs has mentioned this many times, where the man on heroin sits there and smokes a cigarette until it burns his knuckles or something.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. And, my goodness.
So we did a tetrad on the cigarette. As it applies to you and me, our country isn't free, and the law refused to see if all that you can ever be is just a lousy janitor. Unless your uncle owns the store, you know that five and every four just won't amount to nothing more than to watch the rats go across the floor and make up songs about being poor. Blow your harmonica, son.